Hello everyone, welcome back. So I have so many shows that I like, it's so hard to choose. So let's do another star study, and this time I'm going to start off with the grid. And I've come up with a simple grid that you can use on each and every character for this particular anime. So you probably noticed I sometimes take a different approach to making grids for characters, just because some fit and some don't fit and some are a bit more complicated, but this one in particular is pretty simple to follow. So let's start. I'm going to find the middle of the line. Okay. And I'm going to start from the chin. So a line here and around where the hair starts, just because it's an anime, you can actually exaggerate the hair and make it more voluminous if you want to. So having the grid from the, well, where the forehead ends to the chin, it might actually be a bit easier to do. And since I have this space right here, I'm going to cut it in two almost symmetrically, so this one symmetrical to this one, or I guess the same size. And I'm going to cut this one in two as well, so maybe around here and maybe around here, and this is the whole grid. So I want 1, 2, 3, 4 equal parts. So this grid, I can see in this line we have the forehead, this line we have the eyes, this line we have the nose, and this line we have the mouth. And if I apply this grid to each and every character I already have, you will see it's the same. So I have the middle line, I have the chin line. Now the hairline actually goes a bit up, so it's around here somewhere. So I'm going to move the middle line just a bit up, maybe like this. So this part should be equal to this part, approximately. Don't need to be that specific. We have this line here and around this line. Okay, so we have this part equal to this part and this part, and it's the same grid. So here we have the eyes, we have the forehead, the nose, and the mouth and the chin. And if I do the same with this character around here, maybe a bit up actually, because the forehead is around here, and maybe like this. Okay. So we have the eyes, we have the forehead, again it's a bit up, the drawing is cut. We have the nose zone and the mouth. And this works for literally every character. It's a very simple pattern that it's present in all the characters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, almost equal parts. And let's do one more. Here, here, and here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you probably noticed if I were to make another line here, so if I were to cut this zone into equal parts, you can see the tip of the nose where it should be. And I think it's the same here as well. Somewhere around here we have the tip of the nose. Here, so this one equal to this one, you got the tip of the nose. And well, this character is looking a bit down, so the head is a bit tilted down, so I guess this doesn't quite apply. But for this character, since she's looking straight at us, if we do a line here, you can see the tip of the nose. So again, if you have a character with an inclined head, just I guess move this line very, very low. So maybe around here. It's not in the middle because it's not looking front. It's a bit downwards, so around here. And just a small little thing that you can notice is the eyes are not going over this space, so they're smaller than this size, including here and here. So they actually fit perfectly. And I think even for this character, cut it into somewhere around the middle. Cut it here and here. Well, a bit up. This character is also having tilted head, so the nose tip is going to be a bit lower. In this case, you can see the eyes barely go just a little bit under this line. So this line is important to keep the eye space. Well, I guess eye line. So this space is important. That's why you won't really see eyes going way down under this particular line. And the good thing is this grid actually applies to each character, so I think it's really easy to just draw any type of character just by using this grid, because it's the same pattern, so that's pretty nice. Even if they're more mature or more young, the grid is the same. So I also think it's easy to remember, so it's fun. And a line here, maybe a bit down for the nose. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now for the mouth, you can actually move it closer to this line or move it down. So The mouth is a bit more flexible because the mandibula is also moving up and down. And maybe just another small thing you might have noticed is you know how we sometimes in anime we draw very sharp lines for the head? Well, in this case we are going to cut the corners off. So we're going to actually make a very rounded shape. We're going to round up this corner, and this corner. So in that sense, I feel like it's more on the realistic side, since we don't have these harsh edges. And this also applies to each and every character. So we have rounded corners here, here, and here. And if you noticed on this line where we have the mouth zone, we actually start the mandibula turning. So we have this corner, and this corner. This corner, it's turning here on this line. And here. And again, it's a very rounded shape, so don't use harsh edges for the face. And just one more thing that I have observed is usually the ears are on the same line with the nose. So basically the nose starts around here, the corner, and ends here, and the ears should be here. So in this case, I think it's a stylistic choice. The ears sometimes are just a bit up. So if I go back to the other grid, I can actually see on this line. So from the what I consider to be the nose tip, I can see the ear starts here. And it's almost the same length, height as the nose. And for the other characters where you can see the ear, it kind of starts from the nose tip here and ends a bit up and almost the same length as the nose. And again, this one is looking down a bit, but you can see even if he's looking down a bit, the ear is a bit up. Okay. And do I have another one? Maybe here. Seems the ear to start from here as well. And I think here as well. So they're just a bit up. So they're not starting from the end of the nose here. They're starting just a bit up. Just a small thing. I don't think it's that important, but it was fun to notice it. So I think having the rounded, softer face actually complements very well the spiky hair. So you probably noticed all of the characters have very spiky pointing hair. So all of the hair strands actually end in some kind of triangle. So here. And if the hair is closer to the head, it's a bit more rounded, like it's shorter. But if not, you have a very pointy, spiky edges, like this. So I know it's not available for each and every character, so I do have some examples with other characters. Like we have this one that has a more square shape. We have this one that actually, I guess it's more on the square shape as well, but we still have this pointy looking spikes. And we have this character that has a different type of hairstyle that ends a bit more rounded. And this character that also has shorter hairstyle, but it still have that pointy look. And even if you have characters with curly hair, they still end in some small triangle, so they're still spiky. Again, these few characters are so rare that you notice them because they're the exception. However, most of the characters do have very spiky hair, and I think it's complementing very well the very round shape of the face. So it's a nice observation to keep in mind. And just a small note on the color part. We don't really have this type of nuance, so we don't really have very saturated colors that we have here or here, the tip of the triangle. So the color ranges are more somewhere around here, so a bit more grayish tones. And this also sets the tone for the anime. So for example, yes, we do have some funny scenes and it's a funny anime overall. However, we do have some dark themes, some depressing moments, and a more serious tone to the storyline. So this type of color actually influences the mood as well. So for example, we know this one is red, so we don't really have this type of red. This is too strong, so we actually have maybe something around here for what we would call red. And you can see how big of a difference that is, and our perception is that it's still the same color. So it's not like one color is better than the other one, you just have different feelings from it. So, well, for example, this one might be a bit too happy or too carefree, and this one, you know, it's a bit more serious and maybe reliable. You can take it more serious. And it's the same for other colors as well. So let's say for the hair, we don't really have this this type of yellow. This is too strong. This is too happy. So we might have something like this. Well, maybe a bit colorful. Yes, something like this. And for this character, maybe something like this. Or like this. So again, it's a very different tone, and it helps with setting up the mood. Let's try one more color. So for the blue, again, we don't really have this type of blue, or this type of blue, or any type of blue that's up here. We're going to go down maybe somewhere around here for the blue. Maybe a bit darker. And same here, it's a bit more in shadow, so maybe around here. We never go here. Again, it's just a small note, it's a bit of a preference, but it can also help out with setting the mood and have a more accurate drawing. I think I'm going to jump into some quick studies and after that right into the fan art, so I guess I'll see you later. Okay, so I went ahead and made a new layer and just started sketching using the base grid that we've talked about. I also went ahead and tried some color studies for each and every character, and because the color palette is a bit on a grayscale for my own personal color palette that I usually use, I found it just a tiny bit difficult for me. So sometimes I would just place a darker background in the back of the character so you can better see the colors. I also check them with the color pick after I was done and just adjust them if need be. Again, no need to spend too much time on these sketches, they can be a bit loose, it's just for you to understand the colors, the shape, and how you can apply them to your own work. And I think I'm done with this, so I'm going to jump into the fan art. Okay, so I'm almost done, just adding final touches. I'm also adjusting the colors a bit, and I think that's all. I'm going to see you next time. Bye bye.